We did try with an expat team to begin with. And unfortunately in our case, stressing our case, it didn't work out. And during the course of the time, we parted ways with each other. The reason being is, look, in retail in India, there are a lot of dimensions. There is a huge property angle. Where do you want to open a store?
Yeah.
Okay. If you're dealing with a mall, things are relatively more streamlined because you're dealing with a builder of repute. So a lot of things are transparent, you know. But if you're talking about high street, many times there is a middleman. Property could be disputed, title deeds are not clear, and for a company of a corporate stature with high level of audits and everything, you need transactions to be black and white. So, you know, this labyrinth of property transaction, if you don't understand and how to manage it, you will never get your store up and running. So these are some of the, I'm slightly deviating from the main topic, but so therefore in our kind of context, the leadership team people, especially the COO and operations head and things like that, need to have a multi-dimensional experience levels. He should have been a new store opening guy at some point in his time. He should have also handled ops at some point in his time. He should have also handled maybe a bit of buying at some point in this time. So we look at, while it's a general management role, we look at multiple experiences.
Sounds like a mythical creature, actually.
I'll tell you. Some of the very, for example, one of our ops head is actually from Archie's. I tell you, when I met this gentlemen, it is such a niche, and it's a high profile, closely held company. You end up doing everything.
Yes,
you are doing everything. So, while I actually hired him as my head of buying for General Motors, I realized that this gentleman understands property. He understands, and he has a feel for the market. Retail is all about a feel for the market and feel for the consumer. So within 6 months, we just moved him up to offside north. With the store opening team reporting to him, the listing reporting to him. One of the learning in retail has been that you need to quickly identify who are your future leaders. Like I'll tell you, we had this lady in south who actually joined us as a cashier. And after a couple of months, the store manager absconded. Got a better job and he just left. Unfortunately, in retail, many people essentially leave for money. And this lady used to stand in as a store manager. And for 1.5 months, we observed that she was able to do the role of a cashier and a store manager reasonably well. It was not a very big store. It was only about 1,000 square feet. The next store we had, we asked her, do you want to change your line and become a store manager? And she said, yes. So you know, it is also the even as employers, we need to identify whom to move where quickly, how to provide career path, because retail is a very flat structure. You don't have too much of that. So and the other thing is, unlike other industries of vintage, in retail I would say the concept of being a best employer has still not really sunk in. Frankly, barring a company like Shoppers Stop, where I really struggled to hire people because they were very passionate about their brand and that working for their company. Most other retail formats, they would be more than happy to change for additional money. So the only thing, like he talked about emotional connect and the passion. I think the retail in India, that still needs to be developed. And I think organizations and companies need to do some work on it. Because
you touched on one point, I think, which is a sore point with a lot of us, which is that when a client gives us a brief, then they want somebody for the role, and someone who's already been there, done that for that role. So typically, if you're aspiring to grow from say 100 to 500 crores, you want a person to come and do it for you. And our logic is that look, make it aspirational because.